Harper Audio presents Ropa Vieja by Laura Lippman, performed by Linda Emond. Copyright 2001 by Laura Lippman. Production copyright 2008 by HarperCollins Publishers.
Ropa Vieja. The best Cuban restaurant in Baltimore is in Greektown. It has not occurred to the city's natives to ponder this, and if an out-of-towner dares to inquire, a shrug is the politest possible reply he or she can expect. On the fourth day of August, one such native, Tess Monaghan, was a block away from this particular restaurant when she felt that first bead of sweat, the one she thought of as the scout, snaking a path between her breasts and past her sternum. Soon, others would follow, until her T-shirt was speckled with perspiration and the hair at her nape started to frizz. She wasn't looking forward to this interview, but she was hoping it would last long enough for her Toyota's air conditioner to get its charge back. The Cuban restaurant. Local lore about the place, and it had all been dredged up again as of late, held that another name had been stenciled over the door on the night of its grand opening many years ago. The Havana Rum Company? Plantain Plantation? Something like that. Whatever the name, the beacon light had gotten it wrong in the review, and the owner had decided it would be easier to change the name than get a correction. It had, after all, been a favorable review, with raves for the food and the novel for Baltimore gas station setting. If the local paper said it was the Cuban restaurant, it was willing to be just that, and the new name was hastily painted over the old. Live by publicity, die by publicity. That's what Tess Monaghan wanted to stencil above her door. She slid her car into the empty space next to the old-fashioned gas pumps, where attendants had so recently juggled a nightly crush of Mercedeses, Cadillacs, and Lincoln Navigators. Inside the cool dining room, a sullen bartender was wiping down a bar that showed no sign of having held a drink that day, and two dark-haired young waitresses stood near the coffee pot, examining their manicures and exchanging intelligence about hair removal. If Tess had been there for a meal, that conversation would have killed her usually unstoppable appetite. She found the owner, Herb Marquez, in an office behind the bar. The glass in front of him might have held spring water, or it might have been something else. Whatever the substance, the glass was clearly half-empty in Marquez's mournful eyes. His round face was as creased as a basset hound's, his gloom as thick as incense. Even his mustache drooped.
You see that?
He waved a hand at the empty dining room. I saw.
A week ago, maybe, you could have gotten a table here at lunch if you were willing to wait 20-30 minutes. At night, 2 weeks to get a reservation. 3 on weekends. That might be common in New York, but not in Bulmer. I've been in the restaurant business 40 years. Started as a busboy at Old Bricky's. Worked my way up. I opened my own place. Served the food my mama used to make. Only better. And now, it's all over. Because people think I polished the most popular guy in Bulmer.
Most popular?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.